is Jared Wilson. I'm an 11th grader at Churchville Chilai Senior High School, and I have a visual disability. I was born with retinoblastoma, which is a type of cancer that causes tumors to grow on the retina of the eye and causes visual deficiency, sometimes regrowth of tumors in the future. My entire life I've been dealing with the ups and downs of not having use of full vision, especially in a world that revolves around being able to use full vision. I've learned a lot throughout this short 16-year span that I've been alive in coping with different things, adapting to different things. And there's one thing that I've definitely learned is that options and possibilities are almost limitless for anybody with any kind of disability or anything holding them back. People nowadays tend to get caught up in this idea that people with visual disabilities are very limited, but just because they're visually disabled doesn't mean that they don't have just as much of a possibility as anyone else of having some sort of a remarkable gift or talent given to them. And in that aspect, it's definitely ideal to keep your mind open in the aspect that it may be a lot more difficult to adapt to a full vision world. However, it is not impossible at all in any way. The more tools and support that you utilize if you have a visual disability, the higher your chances are to be able to excel in the world. And if you do have any kind of hidden talent or remarkable gift, to actually get that out there and show that to the world and thoroughly use that. We're all given some sort of a talent or a gift, and I think, why shouldn't people with low vision or no vision, why should they not use that talent or not realize that they have that talent? That's just a waste. So I think it's definitely ideal to keep your mind open in terms of that. We're at the point now where, you know, if you wanted to be an architect, designer, a musician, a programmer, an educator, any large number of professions, there are countless ways and adaptations to allow visually impaired citizens to be able to get into that field and express themselves creatively in whatever way they want to for a career, for a profession, and to get noticed for that and to be acclaimed for that. I myself am enrolled in a 2-year program at the BOCES Career and Technical Education Center known as Digital Communications and Media Production. In this class, I do what I love most, which is video editing, cinematography, video production, audio production, which I have a huge interest in. Even at home, I have been able to teach myself a large amount of the ideology behind music production, audio recording, video editing, and this course, of course, actually helps open up my ideas and possibilities in that sense. And the important thing to note there is that both in the home setting and at the BOCES Career and Technical Education Center, there are all sorts of enlargement software that I can use for any computer program I'm using. There's an endless amount of ways to get large text, whether it's on a computer or in hand. I have a portable CCTV. And I like to think that this is a perfectly ideal example of keeping your mind and ideas open, because we're living in the year 2010 and we've definitely taken millions of strides towards allowing visually impaired citizens to be able to fit right in, and if not, actually stand out above other full-sighted citizens. Basically, I think that all of this can be summed up in a single sentence. That is, I am more than what I see.